Another year's gone by. I'm so glad you're with me. The way you lift me up with the love you give me. It's good to know that you'll be mine when days are blue. Oh, what a dream come true.
Welcome to the Orange is the New Black podcast. This is season 3, episode 2, Bedbugs and Beyond. Possibly the best name ever on this show. We are your hosts. I am Rob.
I'm Martha.
I'm Meg.
And Meg, you want to give us a description of this episode?
Sure. Tempers flare when bedbugs invade as Alex cracks, Red lashes out at Piper, Alita interferes with Daya and Bennett, and Caputo gets bad news.
Yes, he does, yes. You guys! Did you see this coming?
So that's... We were just talking about this on the other episode. That's the story of this season, I assume.
So, did you guys see that Litchfield was going to close? Did you see that coming?
I don't think I saw that coming, but I saw something coming. He took over Fig's job, and it's not going to be a walk in the park, especially for Caputo, because he has all the bad luck in the world.
Yeah.
So something had to come.
I knew something was coming, but
I didn't
closing
expect that.
Litchfield is pretty dramatic.
What's going to happen to our ensemble cast?
I don't know how they don't close it either. Like, oh, at the last minute they decided, no, that's not really how the government works.
And it's falling apart.
Yeah, it is falling apart.
And they burned the freaking mattresses, and now they have to go
book,
2 months.
They burned the mattresses
without beds.
Walking around in their underwear.
Yeah,
they were, oh my
gosh.
This
was crazy.
They got very creative on how to create a mattress. So some of them used maxi pads.
More maxi pad use.
Some of them
really
used.
Creative. Alex took the phrase, you could wear a trash bag, very literally in this episode. And she wears it well, giving her props.
Well, she's Alex, yeah.
Of course. They got creative this episode.
Yeah, it was, this was, oh. I am absolutely in love with the season.
I did this. I researched how we portray women's sexuality on television. I just learned so much about it. Seeing Piper, and maybe a lot of people want to say that she's not a good representation of a bisexual woman. And, you know, that we don't have good representation of that on television. At the moment, it's not up to par. However, I don't consider Piper as somebody who's going to have labels this season. So seeing her with Alex and just doing whatever she wants to do in this prison is refreshing as a viewer to see her not bottled up and just people are calling her in season one, she was like, nope, I was a lesbian. And then second season, she was like, I don't know what I am. And now I feel like she just doesn't care, which is great. It is so refreshing to see. And I know I'm not the popular opinion with that. But I also am torn because I don't think it's in her character or in Alex's character to just be like, we hate each other, but that's okay. But again, they might just not care anymore. They're like, you know what? Our lives suck. Like, we have literally been through everything and you ratted me out and Piper threw her under the bus. Like, it's just so much. Like, I don't know if they don't care anymore, if they just want to do whatever they want to do, or if it's out of character for them. But as a fan, I don't really care. They're together. I'm happy.
Well, the thing for me in this particular episode that bothered me the most was Alex's reaction. Piper did nothing. You can't equate it to what Alex did because Alex did it to destroy her life, essentially.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
When she
got her to go to prison, basically.
But what Piper was truly trying to save her life.
I think right now Alex doesn't see that. I think right now
she needs a smackdown.
I think she needs time to see, like, oh my goodness, like, I was out there, I could have been killed, and Piper was doing the only thing she had in her power to do. However, I think Alex is seeing that she was finally out, and now she's back in, and it's embarrassing because she walked around in season one, she walked around like she owned the place. Like she was, she was Alex. She was on top. And now she's back in prison in an orange jumpsuit. I don't think she's in the right
bag in this episode.
Or in a garbage bag, whichever she prefers. But I don't think she's seeing it with a clear state of mind right now. And I don't think she's going to see it. I think she's going to have a rough go about this season. Yeah. She's, I don't think she's going to have a level head this year.
Yeah. And I also think that Piper does, she does things very selfishly. Like she was, like when Red was confronting her this season and saying, you know, how dare you not tell me? You lied to me. And Piper said, well, yeah, I was doing it to spare your feelings. I thought I was being nice, you know? And so Piper makes bad choices and she does things sometimes selfishly. She didn't want to confront Red. She didn't want to have Red kill the messenger. And if she had said to Red, you know, well, the market, it was shut down, you know, the market wasn't there, Red would blame her and say, why did you even tell me? Now I'm sitting in here thinking that, like, no matter what, Piper keeps getting put in the position of you're damned if you do, damned if you don't.
Piper's always in the situation where she can't win. Yes. She doesn't rat out Alex. She might get killed on the outside. She rat out Alex. Alex is going to hate her. So yeah. I think Piper does a lot of selfish things that are stupid, but I think she also does some things of, okay, if it's going to suck regardless, which one would I prefer? So I think that's what happened with Alex. And I don't think Alex realized the gravity of how much in danger she was out in the real world. Yeah. And is prison the safest place? I'm not sure. I don't think
it's
a lot safer than out there, but nobody really wants to be in prison. I think this was also a way to have them both together again and possibly getting out at the same time.
Yeah.
So I think this is setting up.
So if she's got a 3-year sentence or at this point a 2-year sentence, it could put them out within weeks of each other. Mm-hmm.
And if this prison is releasing people for good behavior or for early release, I think this puts Piper and Alex on a really good parallel path.
Mm-hmm.
And that for writing, it might be easier.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I think, though, that Piper needs to admit that there's an element of doing what she did because she wanted Alex with
exactly. her. Yeah. You know? I feel like any excuse she gives at the base of it, Piper's doing what Piper wants to do. Yeah. And I don't think it's going to go unnoticed. I think people are going to say it to her face as they have done before.
Yes. Yes.
So this is going to be interesting. This episode didn't have a ton in it,
but it set up
a lot of bed bugs.
Had a lot of bed bugs.
But it did. It set up with the 2 months now before it closes. Where's everybody going? Caputo might be okay, but the other ones sound like they're all getting fired, you know, or all getting laid off. So it's like, this is going to really just put a bomb in the center of their lives. And it's going to just scatter everybody. This is going to have a whole lot of repercussions.
And are the guards going to figure it out early? Because if they do, are they going to turn into short timers where they just let everything slide? Like this person could go kind of into chaos when this bomb hits.
Yeah, it can. And I don't know if I'm not sure. Like I feel like this episode just set up a lot of stuff. It was a funny episode. It was a fun episode. But at the end of it was like, oh, my goodness, this was fun, but this is a game changer.
Yes.
Right. And this is where it's telling us what this season's about, I think.
Because Bennett, we know now Bennett can't keep the baby. I mean, there's no way he's going to.
No way. And, but I think he realized it when he left the crib at the curb. Like, this is messed up.
So he can't leave it with Cesar. He can't keep the baby. He's got a wealthy, loving woman who wants to raise it. So there's really not going to be a chance. And the freaking mother, Daya's mother, extorted money for herself and Daya. So they're set. When they're out of prison, they are set up for the, life. She's going to pay them Daya. Mostly.
Like, Daya is just trying to do what's best for everybody and trying to do what's best for her and the baby. And she's got so many different people telling her what to do.
Right.
And at the end of the day, that's stressful. Like, what's she going to do with this baby?
Well, and her mom also working against her behind her back for her own gain.
But I mean, think about it. The mom did this where she seduced, wasn't it Bennett that she slept with? Before, when she tricked it,
she
tricked him.
I think she tried to.
I thought she did. I thought.
I'm not sure. We'll have to research that. I'm not sure.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think she did in that first season.
Just yeah.
This is a hot mess.
It is so messed up, and so you know, so we've got you know. The whole heroin storyline. Then we've got the whole baby thing. And now the prison closing and
Alex and Piper.
Alex and Piper. And it's like, this is going to be really, and Red, Red's family is all torn up, you know, and it's going to be really interesting to see how they resolve, because they can't end the season with all these things still hanging there.
I want to know. Let some of it hang.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, a lot of it, I really do like, I think the best stories in this show altogether are the ones that span seasons.
Yeah.
I think it's the most memorable. It's the one that we see the most. So I don't think all of it's going to be wrapped up. I don't think this baby thing's going to be wrapped up either. But I kind of like that. I kind of like that it's comforting that next season we're going to still be with the same things that we know and the same stories. It's not boring yet.
No, it's not. Yeah.
It's so entertaining, but I don't know. Like, I kind of want to know in the writer's room, like, do they have an answer? Is this lost, or like, do you have an answer?
they probably have.
But you know what? I think Lost is a good way to look at it, because Lost
was a hot mess.
But I was a huge Lost fan, but
me too.
If you look at the second season, they didn't know if it was going to get picked up. Yeah. And that's why it kind of stretched and got weird, and it had that one really bad episode. And
they had that one really bad two end of the seasons.
But really, it wasn't until they went, okay, this is how long the show is running. We know how many seasons we've got. Yes. And then all of a sudden it started to click back in.
Yeah.
And I have a feeling last season, let's think about it. This was season two. They didn't know that model had just worked once. They didn't know if season two was going to work. I have a feeling that they were like, well, what is this show? How do we do this? And that's why it went off and became a little more traditional in some respects.
Mm-hmm.
And now I think it's like, okay, we don't know how long they're running, but I have a feeling they've had that discussion and said, we want this to be a 5-year show. We want this to be a 6-year show. And they know now.
Mm-hmm.
I really think that's what we're seeing.
I don't think this is
a 10-year show, you know?
No.
I think it's like Mad Men. What did Mad Men run? 5 years or six?
I want to say six.
I would say we're looking at a 5 or 6 year run on this. Yeah, it sucks when you go, oh man, we might only have 2 more seasons. But maybe that's the right amount to tell this story.
I was just saying this with Bates Motel got 2 more seasons. And I'm like, I love it, and I review it, and I think 2 more seasons is what that show needs to go out with a bang. So if the show has to go out strong, go out strong. If it's a shorter run, if it's a longer run, it's going to fizz out.
Yeah,
it just is so saddening to see. And there's some of my shows that my favorite shows, I'm watching them, I'm like, man, you're getting ratings, but you're fizzing out so hard. Yeah. So I hope that. I trust Netflix. I trust this writing team that they know what they're doing, that this show is going to go out strong. It's going to be one of the best shows to ever be written. I think that this is what's going to happen. And if it doesn't, it'll be really sad to see.
Yeah, I think you're right. And I think that they have so much talent and
so
to
much
work
talent.
With. Yes. And they have a great storyline and a great premise. And I am just dying to see, because we have not seen past this episode. So I am really dying to see what's going to happen coming up and how they're going to.
It's tough to watch it that way, because you do want to binge it. But
of course.
on, but when we talk about it, I can't keep track.
Well,
I
on, watch too many. On the Nuff Said podcast, we're doing Daredevil. And Alil went ahead and watched the whole thing. Just loved it. I don't think Jack did. I have only watched up to what we've reviewed.
Yeah, we're waiting. It's so good.
And I'm a huge Daredevil fan. So it's killing me to not binge this. I wanted to take the whole weekend just like, we're going to watch the entire thing beginning to end. I mean, to me, like a 13-hour Daredevil movie sounds like a dream. But just like with this, it's like, man, we have to not necessarily do it.
Mm-hmm.
And it's tough.
Yeah,
it's
I watched this. I binged it. I'm not done, but I definitely binged it. But I like with this getting to go back and really focus on the episodes, because when you binge, you're just like, I need to see what happens next. And by going back and slowing down and looking at what happens with each episode, you earn more respect for it. And I'm definitely doing that every time. I'm not going to go rewatch season two, but I definitely rewatch season one multiple times, more than healthy. So,
yeah.
I might watch that last episode of season two when he's playing the ukulele out with the nuns. And
I did not watch season two.
Well, and you've got Rose.
You see Rosa. There are elements of season two that are definitely like, if they were on, I'd watch them.
Just the last episode.
I would skip over Larry. I would skip over. There's a lot I'd skip over.
I would just watch the last episode.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. When he's playing the ukulele.
No, I would just watch the previously on Orange is the New Black. And then I would watch season.
Just listen to Megan's recap.
There you go.
Of course.
Go back and we just listen to our podcast and go, we did like it.
Oh, yeah. We like this.
Yeah, so we like that.
Is that it? Did we cover this episode pretty well?
Yeah.
I think we did.
All right. Let's wrap it up. You can find past episodes of this and all of our podcasts at our website, which is www.southgatemediagroup.com. Find us on iTunes and Stitcher and Podomatic and wherever you get your podcasts. Find us there. Please rate us and review us. That can help us more than anything. Getting those rates and reviews, it helps other people find the show. It helps our rankings. So please, even if all you want to do is throw stars on there, that helps, but writing a review helps even more. You can find us on Twitter at SMG Pods. I'm at R Southgate. And Meg, where do you tweet from?
At MEGGH11.
Excellent. And do you have anything else you want to plug before we wrap up?
I'm currently not writing with the TV Junkies, but I have written in the past with them. Go check them out. They're a great site. A lot of our friends are over there. It's thetvjunkies.com.
Excellent. And Martha, do you have anything else you want to say? We're gearing up for Under the Dome.
Oh, my gosh.
That's coming back.
No, I wouldn't say we're not gearing up. We're bracing ourselves.
We're bracing ourselves. The Chester's Mill Report is about to kick back in. And then I've got another summer series. I'm doing the Second Mass Report because Falling Skies is in its final season. I don't know if you watched that one, Meg, but that shows
a
lot of fun.
I've not watched it, but I've been looking at it from a distance.
That's a good binge show, because when I started the podcast with Frank, they had already had, I think, two seasons, and Martha and I binged those first two, and you didn't want to stop, and it was like, I'm going to have to watch weekly.
It's a fun summer show.
It is.
Good.
It's really good. Unlike Under the Dome, which is like having a stroke over and over and over and over.
Well, I will see what they do this year. I almost equated it to Orange is the New Black.
Oh.
So I was like, maybe it'll be, but it's not that, like, they're so not even on the
They're same. Not even on the same playing field.
They're not in the same playground. But anyway,
Maybe it's the new troll too. Maybe that is more accurate.
Maybe they will just be able to somehow make it coherent.
I don't know.
I'm just surprised that it's still on.
It makes money. That's why it's still on.
Oh,
it
didn't
Dwight Yoakam last season, which is a big
Dwight
plus.
Yoakam.
We need him to be a prison guard here on Orange is the New Black. That would be awesome.
Oh my gosh, that would be fantastic.
Yep.
No crossovers between Under the Dome and Orange is the New Black, please.
A dome goes over Litchfield and it keeps him from closing it.
Oh man.
Be the worst. All right, that's it. Thank you so much for listening, everybody. We will talk to you next time. Lord, acknowledge to my good gal, mama. Lord, I have done you wrong.